Good morning, everyone. How are you guys?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing pretty well. Oh my God, can you guys believe that the senior video is due tomorrow?
Are you serious?
What are we gonna do?
I'm not sure. I wanted to talk to you guys, see if you guys had any ideas.
What if we made like a compilation of TikTok videos that we all recreated?
I don't know about that one, Ellie.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that's what we want to do.
Guys, I think I got it. Let's do a PSA on how to stay aligned to CDC guidelines and safety procedures during this pandemic.
Okay, Boomer.
Okay, wait, I think I have a good idea. Everyone loves a good trip down memory lane, right? How about we celebrate all the ups and downs we've had in the past 4 years to reminisce over all the time that's passed?
Yeah, we could take like popular songs from each year and then put it behind memories that were important each year of high school.
I actually really like that idea.
Yeah, let's do that.
Let's work our way from freshman year all the way to senior year.
All right, guys, let's do this.
We are coming on the air right now with the breaking news that the pioneering musician Prince has died at the age of 57.
This is a CBS News special report. I'm Paul Majors in Los Angeles. CBS News has learned that Muhammad Ali is dead. The boxing icon was hospitalized on Thursday with respiratory problems made worse by Parkinson's disease. He was 74 years old.
I must be the greatest!
David Bowie is reported to have died after an 18-month battle with cancer.
The clowns are chasing us up here.
On Facebook, they said there was killer clowns around here that were killing people.
We saw a man with an all-black on, clown mask on, and like a red wig.
Damn, Daniel, back at it again with the white
man. Done it before. Here's the 0-1. This is going to be a tough play.
Seconds. It's over. It's over. Cleveland is a city of champions once again. The Cavaliers are NBA champions.
You did what no other team had been able to do, coming back from a 3-1 deficit in the finals. And
it's time for the spring carnival.
But we're talking about a 400-pound animal. It could be potentially dangerous. It was described as a life-threatening situation for the boy. So within 10 minutes, the zoo officials had to respond, and they deployed a special team that shot and killed the gorilla.
Black Beatles in the city, be back immediately to confiscate the money.
So baby, pull me closer in the backseat of your Rover that I know you can't afford.
Together, we will make America great again. Thank you, God bless you, and God bless America. Thank you.
But so far, we've had a total of 13 named storms, from Arlene to Maria, and we're only a little more than halfway through the season. The hurricanes we've seen this year, and there have been 7 of them, are Franklin, Gert, Harvey, Irma, Jose, Katia, and Maria. 4 have been made.
Okay, here we go. Oh, listen to the cheer. I think it says a lot. Let's listen for a moment.
New state champions, the Royals, have 12 seconds, and they're going to make history here by being the 6th team in the state of Indiana to win a state championship. Ball gets thrown in. The clock is running. The goalie comes out. They're double-teaming, triple-teaming. Shot goes deflected, picked up, kicked out behind. and the ball is on the ground. Lucas DeVoe with 1 second on the clock. This thing's going to be over. Lucas DeVoe checks the clock, walks on the field, waits for the whistle blow, throws it in the air. New championship, Hamilton Southeastern Royals. Congratulations to Coach Beasley and the Royals with an epic comeback in the fourth quarter to win the Indiana High School State Championship for 2018.
It smells like broken here!
I like diamonds, I like stunning, I like shining, I like million dollar deals, where's my pen, bitch I'm signing, I like those Balenciagas, the ones that look like socks, I like going to the jeweler, I put rocks all in my watch, I like texts from my exes when they want a second chance, I like proving wrong, I do what they say I can, they call me Cardi, Cardi, banging body, spicy mommy, hot tamale, hotter than a sock.
Yeah. I've been moving calm, don't start no trouble with me. Trying to keep it peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up at 6 a.m. to cuddle with me. You know how I like it when you loving on me. I don't wanna die for them to miss me. Yes, I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me.
Yeah, I'm gonna take my horse through the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can.
But Parrish, just as come from the low block as she is in the baseline corner, she'd finish with 30, 1 point shy of a record for the 4A state championship game. The Royals, the unquestioned number one basketball team in the state of Indiana, their first ever girls basketball crown, an 11th state championship in school history.
Southeastern, Grayson Drost here with the chopper. Double play, gets out of the inning, but the throw here by Jonah Wickman is wide. Southeastern scores and game over. Anthony Eggers scores the game winner and championship winner. Hamilton Southeastern with their first baseball state title last night. 3-2 the final. The legendary Ken Seitz finally gets the W all along. Of course, for first year head coach Jeremy Sassanelis.
She can't come up with enough. Absolute. Incredible performance. Shock and awe in college basketball. UNBC makes history in Charlotte.
Wherever we go, yes means yes and no means no.
Work your way up to the front of the march, and there she is, a woman who says it's like she's been marching for years.
Yes means yes and no means no.
Bride looking radiant. And then
it thrilled generations of children.
This is the Lego set that I got.
But the shelves at Toys R Us stores across the country are now bare.
Some sad news from the music world. The rapper Mac Miller is dead at the age of just 26. The Pittsburgh native's real name was Malcolm McCormick. He's known for songs including Self Care, Loud, and Smile Back.
Because what we're seeing right now can come up on us within minutes.
Just hold it down. Planning out the coop at the lot, turn the 12 SWAT, buzzing all the bells out the box. I just hit a link with the box, had to put the stick in the box. Pour up the whole field, I'ma get lazy. I got the mojo deals, we been trapping like the 80s.
We've got some stuff to try and wrap our brains around here. Man. I'm Lindsay Rhodes. James Jones is with me here at the desk. We also have Tom Pelissero on the phone. Tom, what is going on here?
Lindsay, Andrew Luck has informed the Indianapolis Colts that he plans to retire.
Michael Lee's breaking news in this Sunday afternoon. Five-time NBA champion, former league MVP Kobe Bryant died earlier this afternoon in Los Angeles in a helicopter crash.
And turn to the sudden and shocking death of rap star Juice WRLD. The 21-year-old, who was named Billboard's Best New Artist this year, suffered a medical emergency at Chicago's Midway Airport.
It's iconic.
There's the pass to Leitner. Puts it up. Yes!
Unforgettable.
To take a three for the win. It's good! Villanova wins it.
Beyond belief. It's what makes March so great.
But now, because of an invisible foe that has yet to be defeated, the NCAA tournament has been canceled.
Avengers!
Assemble. No!
The Outer Banks, paradise on earth. And that's me, John Booker Ravitch. And this is where I live. It's the sort of place where you either have two jobs or two houses, two tribes, one island.
Let's go. Sun is down, breathing cold. That's how we already know. When it's here, my dog will probably do it for Louis Bell. That's just all he know, he don't know nothing else. I tried to show him. Yeah.
Go, now you with the pick and roll.
Get a flame in sickle mode.
Number four, Victor Oladipo is back. What a pass to Sabonis!
A SARS-like virus, which has infected hundreds in China, has now reached the United States.
This is truly an unprecedented situation.
This virus doesn't discriminate. It attacks everyone.
I want every American to be prepared for the hard days that lie ahead.
It has been a joy to work with this group of seniors and their families.
Dear class of 2020.
These past 4 years have been filled with many highs and many lows. And instead of thinking of everything we lost,
we do like to think what we gained.
We're so happy to have been your class officers these past 4 years.
So congrats, class of 2020. Take pride in yourself.
And in the Royals!
Good evening, Fishers High School and Hamilton Southeastern High School seniors.
congratulations on the accomplishment of graduating this year. To the moms and dads, thank you for all your tremendous work and love and support of your family. We're so proud of you here in the city of Fishers, and we can't wait to see what you do. We certainly find ourselves in unprecedented times, but I know that each and every one of you is extraordinary, and you will adapt and evolve and make us all very, very proud. So tonight, reminisce, be grateful, enjoy, and congratulations.
Assalamu alaikum. May peace be upon you all. Wow, wow. Can you believe that it's already May 30th? Can you believe that it's already been 8 weeks of quarantine? Actually, no. Can you believe that it's already been 4 years since we entered high school? I swear it feels like yesterday was the day that we entered that building. And I can't believe that Friday, March 13th was the last day we ever got to leave. It's crazy how time flies. But before I begin my speech today, I'd like to start by making an address to all the families who have been going through economic hardships, to all the families who have been struggling and have lost someone to this pandemic, and to all the healthcare professionals, the doctors, and the nurses. On behalf of the community, I would like to take this opportunity to thank you from the bottom of our hearts for all the sacrifices that you've made. To begin my speech today, I'd like to start off with a somewhat controversial statement. I know a lot of seniors are probably saying, I want my senior year back. But I'm going to be honest, I don't want my senior year back. You know what I want? I want you back. I want my teachers back. The ones who guided me, the ones who mentored me, and yes, even those who assigned me homework due on Friday night. I want all of you back so that I can thank you one more time. I want you back. The close relationships and friendships that I've built over the past 4 years. Whether we were this close or whether we went apart, whether we were friends the whole time or only for just a part, I want to thank every single person graduating for making the past 4 years the best 4 years of my life. I want to share something that I've learned in the past 4 weeks. And what I've learned is that it's always easy to say, how can things get worse? I mean, look at the world around us. Things aren't exactly going our way. But what I've learned is that when you stop asking, how can things get worse? And when you start asking, how can things get better? That is when the world decides to reward you. My friends, I want to share with you the most important thing that we've earned in these past 4 years. Because I'm going to be honest, in 10 years, the grades that we got, the number of likes that we have, or the number of followers that we had, it's not really gonna matter. You know what's really going to matter? Our humanity. Our humanity and the relationships that we've built over the past 4 years. These relationships are what have made our high school experience what it was. And our humanity is one of the few things that this pandemic could never take away. That is because I will tell you what matters. And what matters is the people that we celebrate this graduation with, and our next graduation with, and hopefully celebrate with on our wedding days. Because those relationships are what define our success. Our success is not defined by the number of dollars that we make or the number of cars that we own. But rather, success is measured by the heart. It's measured by humanity, by relationships, and by the joy that we can share with those around us. I implore you, class of 2020, hold on to your humanity. Cherish and embrace the friendships that we've made over the past 4 years. And make new ones in the next 4 years that we will hold for the rest of our lives, because that is how we become successful. Class of 2020, I know you will change the world, and I can't wait. Let's stay in touch, and thank you so much.
class of 2020 will long be associated with transition, change, and challenge. In this last quarter of the school year, we have had to rethink your learning experiences and most of the traditional milestones that mark your passage as students to graduates. The COVID-19 crisis has forced you to rethink how you connect to others and how you define personal success. You could allow yourselves to be mired in the crisis that is reported daily by the numbers, but you could also choose to be the agents of possibility. The economist Milton Friedman wrote, "Only a crisis, actual or perceived, produces real change. When the crisis occurs, the actions that are taken depend on the ideas that are lying around." Your class has aggressively grappled with ideas that challenge our political and social norms. Whether you are a tiger or a royal, think of the work you've done to address issues of equity, to address gun violence, to address the medical needs of ill children, and to address environmental sustainability. Your ideas have not been lying around. They've been tossed, kicked, clutched, crunched, capturing and driving your imaginations and actions. Technology-assisted connections have forced us into new norms of human interaction. In your class, if not your generation, may be the first to witness the harnessing of digital technology to bring us closer to one another. The class of 2020 may, indeed, drive that development. Moreover, you may very well be the driving force to pause or halt global warming, political divides, and the economic divisions. As the superintendent of schools, I regret that you have not been able to enjoy the traditional ceremonies at Fishers and Hamilton Southeastern High Schools that celebrate your accomplishments. However, tonight we are telling you how proud we are of you, and we're doing it in a way we have never done with a graduating class. We're also planning commencement ceremonies that will long be noted as extraordinary for what must have been an extraordinary class. Have you, the class of 2020, been an extraordinary class? It's what you do with your diplomas that will demonstrate your exceptionalism, or not. But my bet is on you. I've seen you in action, and if a crisis is the breeding ground for change, you are the agents of possibility. On behalf of our Board of School Trustees, the teachers, the administration, I want you to know how proud we are that you are walking into the future with a diploma from the Hamilton Southeastern Schools. We will watch with pride as you, the class of 2020, craft the possible.